not exactly a welcoming committee here.
Warren Batista upset. Hey, wait, they're getting
tonight. In the ring. Wait a minute.
And Randy Orton from behind, blindsided Daniel Bryan. He's trying to fight back here at Batista.
Oh, come on, guys. What is this?
A two-on-one mugging by Orton and Batista on the champion.
This is supposed to be a title match between Daniel Bryan and Triple H. What?
Well, we still may have one.
Oh, come on.
This is outrageous. These two guys didn't get the rematch tonight. Now they're taking it out on the champion. He didn't make the decision to defend his title against Triple H.
Well, he was out here gloating. Come on.
Maybe it upset him.
And a KO to Daniel Bryan.
Both men have their reasons for this.
Come on, stop this.
Oh, no, it's like off the RKO, now the Animal Batista looking for the Batista bomb to Daniel Bryan.
Right.
Oh, wait, come on. Not a choke slam.
Daniel Bryan with a knee out of nowhere!
The Shield have stepped into it, and the fairy tale continues to live on. We got a farm animal that's still a WWE World Heavyweight Champion.
Well, the Hounds of Justice have dealt out some justice here tonight on Raw.
Triple H trying to stack the deck tonight against the WWE World Heavyweight Champion, and it backfired.
You can start with it. You cannot win. You can start.
Again, I don't think Orton and Batista are thinking about the Shield at all right now. They're looking to pick apart Jimmy and Jey Uso again. Just bide their time for a possible rematch at the WWE World Heavyweight title.
Locked. Right hand still flying here. Orton a little loopy.
Not for long, though.
Come on, Uso.
You saw how vicious these two men, Orton and Batista, could be last week.
Batista and Orton working together pretty well as a team.
Yeah, that's still surprising to me, but you're right.
That's a scary thought for a lot of tag teams out there right now. Might even be for the Shield.
12,000 plus sold out tonight in Birmingham. Firebuster!
There's the animal.
That could be enough for Batista and Orton. And again, another near fall. Batista barking at the ref.
Come on. 18 world championships between Batista and Orton combined.
Uh-oh, Samoa drop. And that could be the opening the Usos need. Is it enough to put Batista away? You saw Batista buckle. And Randy Orton now going to take the fight outside, right out here in front of us.
No, look out.
Bounced off our announce table. And the Viper coming out of Orton.
I hate when that happens.
The double hey, look at that. Hey. The Shield. Reigns and Rollins and Ambrose attacking Orton. The Hounds of Justice. Batista turns his focus to the Shield, and but Batista, the animal finds himself trapped.
He's surrounded.
They're surrounding, and there's nowhere to go, Big Dave. Welcome to the Shield's yard.
This is not going to be pretty if you're Batista. What's he going to do? Oh!
And Batista trying to ward off the Shield, but there's the Superman punch.
Man, oh man.
Batista may be out.
Maybe. I don't think there's any doubt about it. I think they'll be wise if they're out of here.
What did Batista and Orton say about the Shield not being their problem?
It is now.
Ryback teeing off.
Looks like this Rusev to Swagger to Ryback. This is fun to watch.
Really?
What are you going to do about it? Help me trash anything.
That's the way the Authority plays their games.
You know, this is payback to the Shield. They mess with every single one of these individuals, and now they got to face the day of reckoning. What goes around comes around.
Oh, spear! Uh-oh. And here we go.
Here's the mugging.
Off the spear by Reigns. Sends himself over the top rope. And there's chaos now and a melee developing outside the ring. Look at Seth Rollins. Seth Rollins taking out everybody.
Man, oh man.
The Hounds of Justice trying to rally and regroup.
Hounds of Justice trying to rally.
Hold their yard.
JBL, you said what goes around comes around, and Ryback felt what came around.
They're
still going at it.
Yeah, the Shield trying to hold the ring here.
This Ambrose is unconventional.
They're doing what they can.
So is Bubba Watson. He just won his second ring jacket.
But now this is starting to look like a battle royal.
Yeah, finally.
This is the beatdown I was talking about.
Yeah, the numbers game now against the Shield.
See, the Shield love the numbers game when it's on their side. All of a sudden, it's not on their side. They don't like it so much.
Well, they may not like it, but they're still fighting.
Yeah, but this isn't 3-on-1 or 3-on-2. This is 11-on-3.
So it's better when they had 3-on-1? Wasn't fair either.
Look at Titus O'Neil over there.
That flat-out punishment.
Well, finally, I guess the authority had big smiles on their faces right now.
I better believe Triple H is sitting back there with a big smile on his face.
See, you're back.
All three Shield members are down.
This team that the authority put together is not stopping. I didn't think it could get any worse, but this may go from bad to worse.
The band is back together.
Batista bomb. Oh!
The Shield on the receiving end of that for a change. Doesn't feel so good, does it, boys? Enough is enough, don't you think? This is difficult to watch. Don't cross the balls.
That's a mission statement.
I mean, this is... And out RKO! Come on. It's just like... It's way over the line.
Off the behest of Triple H, the CEO of this company. Look at Ambrose,
trying to fight back.
To help his brethren out, but...
Yeah.
Again, there's nothing left. Oh, look at Batista.
I mean,
Batista bomb!
I mean, what does this prove? These three... It's like three thugs beating up three guys after 11 men have done the damage.
Yeah, I tell you what, it proves you don't spit in the wind, you don't tug on Superman's cape, and you don't cross Evolution. It's the Shield's fault that these guys are back together.
I think these guys are real proud of themselves.
Watch this.
Oh, man.
Just an awful scene.
Yeah. It's another day at the office for the authority, I guess.
Believe in Evolution.
No.
In Evolution!
After more than a month, we welcome back into our forum this week the COO of WWE, Triple H. Welcome.
Thank you. It's good to be back.
What a month.
Incredible month.
Capped off by a successful WrestleMania 30.
Yeah. WrestleMania 30 needed to be the epic event that 30 years of WrestleMania dictated, and I think the WWE delivered on every single level possible.
Many WWE fans feel it delivered in a huge way when Daniel Bryan won the WWE World Heavyweight Championship.
Success is judged on many levels, isn't it? Yeah. You know, a lot of people will look at that as Daniel Bryan just had the biggest fluke win of his life. Other people will look at it and say Daniel Bryan proved to the world that he is everything he says he is, and that's an A-plus player. Well, if Daniel Bryan wants to be treated as an A-plus player, he's going to get his wish.
Are you alluding to what happened on Raw Monday night when your wife, Stephanie, dressed down, berated Kane, claimed he wasn't doing his job as director of operations, and then made it clear that she was ready to unleash the monster Kane. Does Stephanie know what she's doing?
Stephanie is a tremendous motivator when it comes to talent. Does she know what she's doing? Let me put it to you this way, Cole. Sometimes the best way to control an inferno is to just let it burn everything in its path.
Let's talk about the Shield.
Let's.
What happened? I mean, for months, this trio were your go-to guys. Mm. The Hounds of Justice handled justice for the Authority. And now this. Now we're like on the verge of a world war almost.
Mm. I don't know so much about that. Look at it this way, Cole. It's inevitable sometimes that when you give somebody that much power, when you give them that much to hang their hat on, that they start to become full of themselves. The Shield had a tremendous run. Who didn't they put down in the WWE over the course of the last year? They start to feel that power. They want to test that power out. Unfortunately for them, they crossed a line. And they found out what real power, not something given, not something people love you for, hate you for, just power that just is, Cole. They found out what true power is. And they were humbled by it. That would be the term that I would think would stick out the most, and should for everybody, is the term humbled. And I am going to put it to the Shield that this doesn't have to go any further than it has. I want it to be known that I'm merciful, that I'm forgiving, that I'm all those things, and I will do what's best for business every time. I'm willing to forget this and put it off as them spreading their wings and trying to see what they can do, putting their hands on me. I'm willing to forget about all of that. If they want to come crawling back, groveling at my feet, and say that they are sorry, apologize to me for crossing a line, then all this can be forgiven. We can move on, and business as usual. I'll give them till Friday. At SmackDown, I'll address the situation again. If they haven't come back to me by then this story will have a different ending.
Many claim it's your fault for ordering the hit on the Shield by Kane and the New Age Outlaws a number of weeks ago. I just wanted to float that out there.
Many people can claim a lot of things. The truth is, they don't know the reality of the situation.
There is this reality. Monday night on Raw, for the first time in nearly 10 years, you, Batista, and Orton stood together as Evolution, one of the most incredibly devastating groups in the history of sports entertainment. Why?
This is about power. You want to know why? To prove a point.
Triple H calls the Shield the biggest problem that he has to deal with today.
No, we are not breaking this down into a war, okay?
A spear to Triple H!
Find the Shield and tell them they have a match in the main event tonight.
Would you like me to tell them who their opponents are?
No.
But who are they facing?
We're about to find out.
Interesting. So Fandango swept.
What?
Wait a minute.
What the hell is going on?
11 men have been sent out here by the Authority.
Justice comes in all forms.
And here they come.
And the Shield trying to strike first.
These are insurmountable odds for the Shield. That's the way the Authority plays their games.
Oh, spear! And here we go! Look at Seth Rollins. Seth Rollins taking out everybody!
The Shield are holding their ring.
Yeah, the numbers game now against the Shield.
Finally, I guess the Authority's got big smiles on their faces right now. I didn't think it could get any worse, but this may go from bad to worse.
Oh, man. Triple H, Orton, and Batista. One of the strongest factions in WWE history, known as Evolution.
This yard may now belong to Evolution.
Triple H calling off the dogs. And the Shield has now become all three of these men's problem. The Shield have been rendered helpless after being beaten down by 11 men.
Roman Reigns!
Into
it's live here at the Baltimore Arena, First Marin Arena in Baltimore.
Longest limousine I've ever seen here.
Gentlemen, Batista, Triple H, and Randy Orton. It's Evolution. In the house! This is not going to be good, but it is next!
This past Friday night on SmackDown, WWE COO Triple H gave us the news. At Extreme Rules, in 2 weeks, it'll be the Shield versus Evolution.
One of these matches you thought you'd never see. Evolution! Reformed!
Play the Shield for this.
Ladies and gentlemen, Randy Orton, Batista, the CEO of WWE, Triple H. Evolution!
You are witnessing history tonight, live on Monday Night Raw. And if you'd like to discuss the reunion of Evolution, you can do so by using the hashtag Evolution for
versus Shield right now on Twitter. And we never thought we'd see today the reunion of one of the most powerful groups in sports entertainment history.
Well, you're exactly right about that, but we are witnessing it right now. This is history-making.
And, John, one of the beauties of the WWE Network is you can go back in time and you can see what made Evolution great. You were in your prime, John, during the Evolution era. What was it about this group?
I thought it was the greatest match of all time then, and I think now, looking back, they were. Now we're going to see a battle of perhaps arguably the two greatest factions of all time, Evolution versus The Shield. And remember, Michael, in this group alone, there are 31 world championships between these three men.
And if you don't believe what we're telling you about them, all you got to do is go on the WWE Network, hit the search box, and just check it out. See it on yourself. See what Evolution was like.
The crop then, or the cream of the crop now.
You know, I laugh every time I think about it. Imagine what it feels like. Imagine what that had to feel like. You tell the whole world that you were the baddest guys on the planet. Week in, week out, you tell the world you were the baddest people around. And then one day, your daddy comes out and he spanks you in front of the world. That's humiliating. That is humbling. And that, quite frankly, is just the beginning.
Sometimes all it takes is a single spark to set the world on fire. In this case, it was one careless act by The Shield that set in the motion of the gears of their destruction. And that is the reformation of the most dominant, fiercest group ever. Evolution. Now, in case you've forgotten,
just like in life, everything evolves. And what you see in this ring before you is the greatest example of evolution you will ever see. The most destructive force that WWE has ever seen. Batista, the Viper, Randy Orton, and the Game, Triple H. Destruction, true destruction. Power, true power. When you set out on a journey to find where that line is in the sand, don't cross the line. There's a simple rule in life. You either adapt or you perish. That is evolution.
Are you starting to get it now? Is it becoming clear? 31 world titles in this ring between the three of us. The Shield has absolutely no idea what they've gotten themselves into. Deal with that.
Here we go.
They may just deal with that.
I guess we're going to find out.
This is great.
Evolution's also about survival of the fittest.
Come get you some, boys.
And the Shield, the House of Justice, believe they're the fittest. Ambrose, Robbins, and Reigns, and John, they believe the ring is their yard now.
Wait a minute. Where's Evolution going?
Looks like they're giving up the yard. Perhaps a little mind game from Evolution. Maybe they're concerned.
Hey, I hate to break it to you guys, but last week wasn't the first time we've been beaten up, and it probably won't be the last. Yeah. You guys did a real number on us. Well done. Well done. But hey, I got a question for you, Mr. Cerebral Assassin. Do we look humbled to you? Do we look humbled to you, Triple H? Hey, there's a reason you hired us to protect you and that little cream puff to your left, Randy Orton. Oh. You know, like everybody here knows, the Shield, we are the meanest, nastiest, dirtiest, most ruthless animals in this industry. These dogs are hungry, and now these dogs are angry.
Yeah. Take it easy. Yeah, you're angry. You're angry, and you have every right to be. We have every right to be angry after what you did to us last week. You and, what, 12 other guys, of course. But, Batista, for you to say that we have no idea what we've gotten ourselves into is ridiculous. We have every idea. We started this. So let me give you a little dose of reality. You stand up there in your little suits. You don't want to fight. You talk about how destructive you are. You talk about how powerful you are. Talk about how you were built for dominance. Well, you're not. In 2 weeks, at Extreme Rules, you're gonna come face to face with the Hounds of Justice. And it's gonna be all out war. And when push comes to shove and you got nowhere to run to, you're gonna be looking out for you for Evolution? I don't think so. Randy Orton, the Viper, gonna be looking out for Randy Orton. I know, Batista, you got a lot of Hollywood obligations. You're going to be looking out for Batista. And the game. Cerebral Assassin, King of Kings, yeah. You're going to do what you always do. You're going to do what's best for the boss. What you're looking at is the most dominant force in the history of this company. And in 2 weeks, at Extreme Rules, we are gonna rip you to pieces. And this little reunion that you're so proud of, it's gonna come to an abrupt halt. And you got no one to blame but yourself, because when you made the match, Evolution versus the Shield, you put a nail in your own coffin. And at Extreme Rules, we're gonna be the hammer that drives it home.
Last week, you gave us an ultimatum. This week, we give you one. Here in a few seconds, I'm going to drop this mic, and we're coming up that ramp, and we're going to beat your asses. You got two options. You can be men, and you can try to fight. Or you can be cream puffs, and you can cower away, and you can hide. Watch.
Uh-oh. Where's it gonna be? Here comes the Shield.
Oh, look at this.
Oh, please.
Wait a minute.
Option three. There's always an option three. Listen up, boys. I said it once, I'll say it again. In life, you either adapt or you perish. That is evolution.
In Extreme Rules, because it'll be Evolution versus the Shield.
Yeah, but is this just an example of what we can expect? Is Evolution always going to be one step ahead of the Shield?
Well, it has been a startling and shocking night tonight on Monday Night Raw. It all began with Stephanie McMahon addressing WWE World Champion Daniel Bryan and his new wife, Brie Bella.
Nature Boy, 16-time world champion, styling and profiling. Looks better than ever.
Is this St. Louis, Missouri? Have I ever been here before? Well, I have, and I've had a lot of fun, thank you. But what I'm here tonight is to tell the whole world that it's great being in the ring with men that exude what this business is all about, dominance. Now, I ran for years with the Four Horsemen. Ran up and down the road, we ran wild. But we controlled the marketplace. We styled, woo, and we profiled. The same can be said for Evolution. Good Lord, Dave. I miss seeing you out on Saturday night. You too, buddy. You were always home eating a ribeye. You know, in my years on the road, I have seen everything come full circle. And I mean the word greatness come full circle. And tonight, I'm surrounded with superstars that exemplify power, style, and grace. But what I'm talking about now is the Shield.
He just double cross Evolution?
Wait a minute.
How would Flair do that?
Wait a minute. Wait a minute.
Ric Flair, he just offered his endorsement to the Shield.
He just slammed Evolution here. Wait a minute.
He's still trash talking. Look at Batista. Batista up on the apron, and Triple H just yanked the leg of Roman Reigns. And Orton off the distraction.
Well, Evolution saw what was coming.
And there's the backbreaker. And wait a minute. Dean Ambrose and Rollins. Gronk and Batista, Triple H, and here we go.
Boy.
The fight is on. The fight is on. The brawl is on out here at ringside. Ambrose and Triple H right in front of us. Batista and Rollins. And there's Ambrose right across the table. Dean Ambrose set across the table. Triple H now with the fight on. And now it's Evolution with Ambrose and Rollins down. Roman Reigns in the ring with a Superman punch. A Superman punch by Roman Reigns as the fight continues outside the ring. And now Reigns going to get involved out here. Reigns to Triple H, Batista this match. Referee has no control, but the brawl, the melee, the chaos continues out here. Look at Reigns go.
This is a battle over supremacy.
Now Orton's getting involved in the fray, and it's a three-on-one, guys. Evolution's got Roman Reigns three-on-one.
Not very often you see the numbers game work against the Shield.
Come on, Dave, kick him.
Now Batista dragging Ambrose over our announce desk and back into the fray again. It bounces in Ambrose right off. This is a wild scene here at ringside. Evolution, utter destruction of the Shield. And now Rollins off the barricade.
Hey, this is all the Shield's fault. You know it. They're the reason that Evolution is back together. I can't imagine how bad it's going to be this Sunday. Maybe Nature Boy needs to come back down here and endorse the other team.
And a spine buster outside to Dean Ambrose.
It's usually true. What goes around comes around. Oh, man.
They are shredding the Shield.
I expect any moment we're going to see an RKO, a pedigree, a Batista bomb. You want to go down as the greatest of all time? Step in the ring with them and beat them.
This is brutal.
They have awoke a sleeping giant.
Triple H going for the pedigree. Look at Rollins! Look at Rollins! Seth Rollins! And now the Shield go after Orton! And now the Shield with a rally!
Oh my God.
The Shield with a rally!
Randy Orton dispensed it now!
And Batista! And Triple H has no backup. Smash!
Triple H is down. Look at him writhing in pain.
Are they gonna? They're gonna try?
Oh, no,
are they gonna try?
Oh no.
The Shield gonna try?
This one is up.
No!
Orton and Batista with chairs thwarted. Triple H manages to roll out of harm's way.
Watch out.
Folks, we have a collision coming Sunday.
We got a war coming Sunday.
The established Evolution, the upstart Shield. Will the Shield adapt or perish?
Just when the Evolution thought it was safe to go back in the water.